this is a what hospital is this? Can you hear us? This is Dr. Narayan here, and we have with us Dr. Pinto in the chair, and Dr. Samir Mehrotra as a panelist. Can you hear us? Yeah, we can hear you. Go ahead and tell us about your case.
Yeah, we can hear you. You can hear us?
We cannot see the angiograms nor.
First show the angiogram. Yeah, this is the angiogram. Are you able to see? Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
There's a big diagonal. Go to the next one. Big diagonal, very tight to stenosis of the diagonal margin. Next. Go to the next. See here, very tight stenosis of the diagonal and LAD compared to LAD. Diagonal looking more tight. Just we did the OCT study of the LAD RAM, which showed 1.7 square millimeter. Very, very tight stenosis of the LAD also. We'll show the OCT RAM. You can show 3D reconstruction of the OCT was done. You can. Thick fibrosis, almost encroaching under the OCT catheter, very tight lesion. It's more of fibrosis. We don't see any calcification. So thick fibrotic lesion, and OCT wise area estimate is about 2.8 to 2.9 square millimeter, and this is a LMC area. So already we have crossed the LAD and diagonal. Go to the, that is Shia blue into the diagonal and BMW into the LAD, pre-dilated with 2.5 balloon in the diagonal and 3mm balloon of LAD. And subsequently we implanted one BBS into the diagonal. So then this is post-dilatation. We can see the almost like a T-stenting. So at the time of implanting the BBS, what we did, we put the 3mm balloon and inflated. Well, we wanted to see that only encroaching onto the ostium of the diagonal. So in order to avoid extension into the LAD, so we inflated the LAD balloon and pulled it. Then when the LAD balloon is inflated, then it's dilated. That is, you can see the two markers of the BBS stent already implanted. Post dilatation was done. That is 3mm balloon, 3 to 15mm balloon. Again, post dilatation of the BBS of the diagonal was done with 3 to 8mm balloon. So now we'll be implanting the BBS to LAD, give the BBS. Any questions or any suggestions from the panel?
So what basically you set up this bifurcation strategy, correct?
Yeah,
V-stenting. So you want a V-stenting with two BVS?
Yeah, V-stenting with BVS. Because LAD is also very, very tight.
Right.
Within a 111.
Right.
Though angiographically it was not looking that tight, but only LAO cardinal showed LAD very tight. So we wanted to move it with OCT. OCT showed the LAD MLA is about 1.7 square millimeter, very, very tight, almost
right.
Encroaching onto the OCT catheter.
Right. I you know, just want to know, what is your kind of follow-up for these kind of BVS patients where you do bifurcation? Have you been doing this regularly, and do you have some kind of a follow-up strategy on this?
Yeah, we have been doing for the past 3 years. Actually, one of my first BVS bifurcation, that way, where we did LCS and OM bifurcation, two BVS, one is 3.5 to 18, another 3 to 18 stents for implant and OM and LCS. He completed 2 years, 9 months recently. Actually, he was supposed to come today for a OCT follow-up study. We wanted to show today that follow-up study also. But unfortunately, he is coming next week. So we did almost 20 cases of bifurcation. In that one, two-stent strategy we did for 3 patients, remaining all like provisional stenting. Only thing is, when all cases were done with BVS, but last 3 months, almost we implanted 108 BVS so far. But all are doing very well. We didn't have any mortality. Only one patient died. That is because of the, not because of the acute coronary disease. He had a false car malaria, elevated LFT. And that time the patient had a recurrent refractory angina. For that sake, the mortality was due to some other. But we didn't have any other mortality.
Doesn't become a life.
One little question, that since you showed a lot of fibrotic issues in the OCT, you said the lesion was very fibrotic and you plan to implant a BRS or a BVS, how would you modify that lesion? Do you use a routine balloon or you would use an angiosculpt, etc. to sort of?
Angiosculpt can be used, but it's healing very well, nicely. You see, balloon expansion is very smooth. For that sake, we need to use the really very not healing. Definitely we have kept the 2.5 to 12 mm of the cutting balloon also, but we wanted to go into cutting balloon only if it is not healing. But I am very comfortable because the OCT image did show it's a very thick fibrotic, but it's healed very well.
Two questions. One is, what about your dual antiplatelet strategy with BVS, especially bifurcations? Are you using the more potent antiplatelet agents? So are you still continuing with clopidogrel? Are you using ticagrelor or something of that sort? Do you have any specific strategy?
Our BVS patients, most of the time, they will be on ticagrelor, this is aspirin combination, loading dose 90 milligrams.
Continued for
2 months. Most of the time, we keep for 12 months, but nowadays, we are waiting for 3 months, and after that,
okay,
some patients, when they are saying some problem with aspirin, initially they are saying some financial issue, then most of the time in this patient, they don't have any financial issue.
I think if you put BVS, there is no financial issue at all. So, my second point to you was about the preparation of the bed, which he was also asking out over here. I'm just asking you about the preparation of the bed, of the bed pre-implantation of the stent. Do you follow an OCT strategy in all your BVS patients, or do you do it only selectively? Can you hear?
Yeah. Already adequate preparation was done, because the OCT size was about 2.8, it was dilated 3.8. Even diagonal was dilated 2.5 mm.
So I just wanted to ask whether you use the OCT in all your BVS patients. Not clear.
Do you use the OCT, Dr. Sridhar? Do you use in all patients or in selected patients?
Yeah, 90% of BVS patients we use OCT, but sometimes recently we did bifurcation primary PCA, the midnight, a very young patient, like 37 year old. So he had a natural lateral effect, he had a diagonal total occlusion and LA reached tight here. Because 37 year old, for that sake, what we wanted to provide the BVS for that.
Dr. Sridhar, once you implant the BVS, then we'll go off to Bangalore after that. Can you just proceed?
We're going to the other.
One question. Sir, see, you are putting two BVS. So would you like our people sitting here to know whether you are going to have some change in your technique? when you are putting a BVS compared to 2DS? And secondly, are you going to do OCT after putting the BVS also?
Yeah, after OCT, after BVS compulsory, we have to do the hypothermal incident. So, we did the like a BVS, then we went for high pressure, and subsequently, patient had a BVS fracture, and which was a restricted metallic BVS. So, particularly when size mismatch, when we think like a 3.5, but actually sizing is very, very particular in BVS, only 5 mm. So if you took the right step for the right vessel, definitely it's a good step. Only thing is OCT post-follow-up compulsion, like any blood products is there, have you missed any dissection is there, malocclusion is there, suppose good occlusion is there, definitely if you are not missing the dissections, definitely long-term outcome will be very good. That was shown in IVUS studies as well as the preliminary OCT study has shown TLR, TVR, less definitely the long-term outcome will be much better than through the imaging.
Okay. In your clinical practice, have you given up the hybrid strategy for bifurcations? Is it all the time going to be 2 BVSs or 3 BVSs or?
No, most of the time it is, I think fibrous calcification is there, very casual, we use metallic BVS, and depending on the strategy, we discuss those strategies. Even today for bifurcation, 90% we use DS only, but sometimes depending on the good vessels, only focal lesions, very short segment lesions, where remaining vessels are normal in such cases, I would like to more often use BVS compared to DES.
Dr. Sridhar, we would like to go to Bangalore. If you want to do something, please can you show us immediately?
Yeah, BVS will be
there. Thank you. That was a nice case. Can give him a big hand.
Not yet finished.
Not yet finished. You want to do another case?
No, no.
Another part of the case? I thought you're going to Bangalore.
No, no, we are. After he's going to implant a BVS, I think one more.
He showed us some part. No?
Yeah, he showed
still
one
doing
part.
Some.
He's going to absorb.
He another wants to put another one?
Yeah.
Okay. I thought he had finished.
So we're going to Jaydev.
Okay. Can we? Okay. Sridhar, we'll come back to you in about 10 minutes' time. We'll just see what Jaydev has lined up for us.
Okay, thank you.
Can you go to Bangalore, please? Can we go to Bangalore, please, Pratham? Nahi? Nahi? Okay, Sridhar, you are in luck. Jaydeva is not fully ready. There's some problem in the lab, so mechanical problem, not a patient problem.
So now tell us what you're going to do before you do it, because the last time you did it and then we saw it. So tell us now what you're going to do.
Let's see this case first. Yeah, okay. Yeah, okay. Can we go to Bangalore, please?
Okay. Yeah. Wait. please.
Are we going to Bangalore? Hi.
Do we have any questions or comments from the audience? Dr. Sridhar, can you just continue to tell us what you're doing, because it's been rather quiet this end.
Can't hear us.
Give me another mic, ready mic. Is it mic? Yes. We'll put the another mic.
What are you doing, Dr. Sridhar? Let us know.
No, actually, because mic is aligned to the start, so sometimes you will have to go. In that case, what you go second mic, body mic, and to avoid the mic. So what happens to these bypasses is very common in BBS. Most of the time, when the bike is aligned with the stud, so the balloon cannot cross. In that case, you better take another bike and cross it, and then overside you put the balloon.
Cool. So now you're putting a buddy wire?
Pressure on.
Sridhar, we are back with you. Can you tell us and show us some final results or something?
Yes, we are able to. The second BVS that you implanted was what size?
Pardon?
Size?
3 to 28.
How much?
3 to 28.
Right. 3.5 up to 10. You didn't take very high pressure because you went with a 0.5 size higher. That's why.
We had a presentation, earlier presentation, and Dr. Praveen Chandra was emphasizing that this post dilatation could go up to really high pressures of 28 to 30. So what is your view on that? I mean,
I basically go high pressure. I never take my this thing up to just 10. I usually go very high pressure with the BVS because I believe that you really need to implant it adequately. I may take, I may not take. Yeah.
Dilatation for BVS is quickly up and down like other drug eluting stents or slow up and?
No, when you're implanting the stent, it is slow. But when you're post dilating, it's normal.
It's like other DES.
That's right.
We'll have a look at the OCT from Dr. Sridhar and then go off to Bangalore because they are now ready, I believe, finally. Very brief moment, we'll go back to Sunshine. And Dr. Sridhar?
Thrombus, then we can thrombus migration, go back.
go back. Before that, you should go back. You are moving forward, backward. Back on next. You see, there is laziness in the sex last year. Go to the next. Next. No, forward. Go to the next. Last. Forward. Fast. Then L6 was dilated. So this patient had a severe LFCA and the distal LCS lesion, diagonal lesion, and middle AD to distal AD lesion. The patient was treated with two alpha extents LFCA and LAD and one alpha extent to distal LCS. Two key six were done. One is like a LFCA and LAD, LFCA to LAD, another one LAD and diagonal. So just before this case we finished, just we wanted to share this case. Any questions or any suggestions?
Sorry if I missed, but did you do any stenting into the circumflex or only balloon dilatation of the circumflex?
No, circumflex was stented. The practical LCS was not stented. It's only kissing.
Only kissing, no? Only kissing into the circumflex.
Same he did with
Okay. So you just did a kissing into the circumflex.
Yes. Post-kissing ability is looking very nice.
Yeah. Yeah, these are the only thing is that what is proven in these patients is that the highest site of restenosis is the circumflex ostium, you know. So this patient should have a repeat angio done after 3 to 6 months to look at the circumflex ostium, because you'll have a very high percentage of patients who come back with restenosis.
Yeah.
So if you had a disease-free circumflex ostium, why did you do anything over there?
Pardon?
You said that you had a disease-free circumflex ostium. Is that correct?
No, circumflex
ostium absolutely disease-free. No, once you say disease-free ostium, then you do not need to touch the circumflex ostium unless you can keep a wire there and you can do the... No, I'm just a point of view, not to say... A point
this
of so if you had just tented the left main to LAD, kept a wire down your circumflex, even if you have a minor plaque shift into the circumflex, but if you have a TIMI 3 flow into the circumflex, there is no need to do anything about that circumflex. If you have significant disease in the circumflex, since you had the fair enough. Fair enough.
Thank you, Dr. Sridhar, for showing two wonderful cases. A big round of applause from the audience, please. A big. Thank you very much. Right? We'll take your leave. Thank you very much, chairpersons.